is this file? Oh, you're here. I had this app image file and I can't find it. So now is not a good time. I'll see you later. Bye. Where is it?
Hello and welcome.
So as you might have noticed, app image applications have become quite popular in the Linux world in the few recent years. And it can be understood. They're really easy to download. They are distributed as one single file and they work out of the box on every major distro out there. Now, when you download an app image file, you can just double click on it and it will start. But you usually won't be able to start it from your app launcher or app drawer or menu, whatever you call it. Luckily, it's really easy to add it to the menu, so let's see how it's done. So I have here the Nextcloud client, and of course it's just an example. It can be any other app image or actually any other application. First, I'll move it to a new folder, which I'm going to call Applications. Now we have to make sure that the app image itself is runnable, and for it I'll right click on it and choose Properties. And under permissions, I'll make sure that I allow execution. Let's now open the home directory of my user. And I need the .local folder. It's a hidden folder, so I first need to make the hidden files visible. And let's open the share folder. And here the applications folder. We're going to create here a new desktop file. Linux will recognize this file, and that's how it will know to add the application to the menu. So let's save the file and name it nextcloud.desktop. I'm not going to write the file from scratch. I'm going to use a template. I found one in the Arch Wiki and I'll add a link down below. We now need to change the name. For the executable, I'm going to specify the full path, the folder, and the app image file itself. And I'm going to remove the path. I don't have an icon at the moment, so I'll remove this entry, and I'll also remove categories. Let's save the file. We now need to update the desktop database. And again, I'm just going to copy it from the Arch Wiki. And when we open the menu now and look for Nextcloud, we can see it right away. We can also add an icon. And let's update the database again. And when we look for Nextcloud now, it has its icon and we can open it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.